Today, I'm going to tell you what a hyperbole is, the meaning of the word hyperbolic, and who a hyperbolist is. Hyperbole, hyperbolic, and hyperbolist. These three words. So if you want to know more, do watch this video. If you guessed that a hyperbole is a literary device, then you are right, it is. But before I begin, let me introduce myself. I'm Milene from English Made Easy, where you can find easy and interesting lessons to improve your English in an enjoyable way. This is how you pronounce the word hyperbole. The stress is on the second syllable, hyperbole. Hyperbole. A hyperbole is nothing but an exaggerated statement that cannot be taken literally. It is an exaggerated way of describing something, and not just a modest or acceptable exaggeration of something, but an extreme exaggeration. For example, if I say, "My neighbor is taller than a skyscraper." Isn't that an extreme exaggeration? My neighbor is taller than a skyscraper? Such a statement would be a highly exaggerated one, as no man can possibly be taller than a skyscraper, leave alone being as tall as one. A hyperbole is a common literary device and is used in storytelling to make everything more interesting. It is a simple technique, but can create a profound impact on the listener or the reader. Here's another example. If I do not meet my brother tomorrow, I will die. I mean, something like that is not really possible, is it? If you do not meet your brother, you cannot die. So it is an extreme exaggeration. So it is a hyperbole. Here's another one. I am so angry with you that I will explode. I am so angry with you that I will explode. That's not possible either, is it? You cannot be so angry that you will explode. So it's an exaggeration again, and not just a mild exaggeration, but a profound one. Listen to this one. The teacher was so wild that he could have killed someone. The teacher was so wild that he could have killed someone. Again, it's very highly exaggerated, isn't it? The teacher would not have been so wild that he would have killed someone. But here are some that you might have heard before. They're quite common. You might have heard them and not given much thought to it. You may have not noticed that it was a hyperbole that you were using. Listen to these. I am so hungry I could eat a horse. Heard that? I'm sure you have. I'm so hungry I could eat a horse. It's a hyperbole. Why? Because it is an exaggerated statement. No one could ever be that hungry that they would eat a horse. You might have heard this one too. I'm dying of hunger. A very common one, isn't it? I'm dying of hunger. Well, it's not really possible. It is highly exaggerated, because it's not possible to die of hunger unless you have been starving for days. So it is a hyperbole. And maybe you heard this one too. My bag weighs a ton. My bag weighs a ton. Again, it's a hyperbole because it is exaggerated. No one's bag would actually weigh a ton, and if it did, you wouldn't be carrying it around, right? I think many of us have used hyperbole without realizing what it is. Well, now you know it has a name, and you know what the name is: hyperbole. Your hyperbolic speech can actually impress people, and if you use a lot of good hyperbole, people will start calling you a remarkable hyperbolist. If you noticed, I have used three different words right there: hyperbolic, hyperbole, and hyperbolist. the three words that I showed you in the beginning. Here, hyperbole, hyperbolic, and hyperbolist. These are the three words that I'm going to do in this lesson today. So now you know what's a hyperbole. It's an exaggerated statement, a literary device that people use to make the speech and writing more interesting. What's hyperbolic, and what is, and rather, who is a hyperbolist? Let's move on and find out. So the adjective form of the word hyperbole is hyperbolic, the adjective form. For example, you could say his hyperbolic speech is impressive. His hyperbolic speech. So you are describing his speech and saying it is full of hyperbole, and hence it is hyperbolic. That is an adjective there. And hence, if you want to use the adjective form of hyperbole, you use the word hyperbolic. And who's a hyperbolist? A hyperbolist is a person who uses hyperbole. A person who uses hyperbole is called a hyperbolist. You could say he is a pathetic hyperbolist if he's not good at all. Or if he's really good at it, you could say he is a great hyperbolist. What about you? Would you like to be a hyperbolist? Would you like to use hyperbole in your speech or writing or both? I'm sure you would, because it is impressive to use these things in your speech and writing. A hyperbole is also very similar to a simile or a metaphor, because these figures of speech also involve comparison of things. A simile compares two things using the words like or as, while a metaphor compares things without the use of these words. I have done an earlier lesson describing the differences between a simile and a metaphor in detail. The reason I'm talking about a simile and a metaphor here is because they can overlap with a hyperbole. They overlap with hyperbole. I'll tell you how. For example, my sister is as tall as a skyscraper. My sister is as tall as a skyscraper. So the sentence is a simile because it compares my sister to a skyscraper, and it's using the words as tall as. So it is a simile, but it is also a hyperbole because it is an exaggerated statement. Why is it an exaggerated statement? Because my sister could never be as tall as a skyscraper. Here's another example of how a simile can overlap with a hyperbole. My grandfather is as old as the hills. My grandfather is as old as the hills. So in this statement, I am comparing my grandfather's age to the age of the hills. I'm comparing both and using the word as. My grandfather is as old as the hills. And while I'm comparing both and using the words as, that makes it a simile, but it also makes it a hyperbole because I am exaggerating my grandfather's age. Hills are really old. They can be ancient, and no one's grandfather could ever be that old. So it is a highly exaggerated statement. That makes it a hyperbole, right? So it is a simile as well as a hyperbole. So these things can overlap. A metaphor can also overlap with a hyperbole. With that, I've come to the end of this lesson on hyperbole. Leave a comment below with a hyperbole. It may be something you have used in the past, or maybe something you plan to use. Until we meet again, practice what you learn. That will help a lot.